Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. Let's extend the idea of enamines as nucleophiles by reacting them with acid chlorides. On the top of the slide is the Stork enamine alkylation, which we saw in the previous video. We take a ketone and make an enamine. React the enamine with a primary alkyl halide. A key idea is that the enamine, with the nitrogen feeding electron density into the alkene, is nucleophilic enough to attack the alkyl halide. This forms an iminium ion, which can be hydrolyzed to an alkylated ketone. This reaction works great. Well, if enamines can attack alkyl halides, then what else can they attack? As it turns out, they also attack acid chlorides. On the screen, we have a process that begins like the Stork enamine alkylation. Start with a ketone, make an enamine. Now let's react the enamine with an acid chloride. The alkene attacks the carbonyl, makes a tetrahedral intermediate, and the chloride is kicked out. The resulting iminium ion can be hydrolyzed to reveal a reacted ketone again. The product of this process is not an alkylated ketone, but an acylated ketone. This product is called a 1,3-dione. 1,3-diones are incredibly useful molecules for the synthesis of certain types of aromatic molecules. This process of making 1,3-diones is called the Stork enamine acylation. 1,3-diones are an example of, and now I'm on the far left, active methylene compounds. They have a carbon, often a CH2, but in our case, it's a CH between two electron withdrawing groups, in this case, two carbonyls. You have perhaps seen molecules like this from the Claisen condensation, which makes beta-ketoesters. Active methylene compounds have their own branch of chemistry, some of which appears in other playlists on this channel. We've now learned about the Stork enamine acylation. It's an excellent method for making 1,3-diones from enamines and acid chlorides.